Taku, I need your help. Taku, help me! Oh my god, Taku, stop ignoring me! Hey guys, today we're gonna find out how to build your best RTA pool. So the first thing you wanna do is to know the meta. What monster is actually relevant at the moment, and what works in the combination? Now to find out, most of you would probably go to YouTube, type in RTA tier list, and see what monsters are relevant, right? But I don't recommend doing that, because first of all, the meta keeps on changing. Second of all, you know, these people may not know what they're talking about. They might not even be an RTA players or even a top rank players. G1 player, by the way.
No one asked you, bitch.
The best way to know the meta is to see it with your own eyes. And I'm gonna show you just the best way to do it. Just go to your arena, world arena, go to spectate, replay, and click on best. Don't click on my battle, but click on best. Now here you can see the top players and what monsters they're using to climb this high. Let's see what's the meta of Season 12 RTA. Ooh! Just by looking at this, I can know that the meta is actually Tank Shot. Or as I like to call it, Bruiser with one-shot potential. Now this is actually the meta that I see, thanks to Taranis. What else is the meta? Aha! The meta is CC. 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 And another CC. Just from looking at these 3 matches, I can tell that CC combination is now the meta. So, there you go, 2 meta already, the tank shot and the CC. Also look, most of this CC comp has 1 AoE stripper, 1 AoE stripper, 1 AoE stripper. Now do you see the meta? 1 AoE stripper in the CC comp. It's really easy to do, guys. Understanding the meta, you can just go over here and just observe. Alright, now that we understand the meta, the next thing you should ask yourself is whether or not, can I make that comp? If not, then can I make a comp that can counter the meta? At least to deal with the meta. This is where we realize that life sucks and not fair. Some reservoir RTA is just so pay to win. Of course, you're not gonna have all the monster that is meta. Of course, you cannot just copy paste the comp you see from the best replay, because we don't have all the monster, right? We only have so much monsters available from the meta. So for the monster that you lack, you gotta find a substitute. Basically, we gotta adapt. For example, if I don't have Hathor, I make up with my other CC, like Etna or Azubel. And if I don't have a Chiwu, I make up with the Fire Pierrette or Clara. See, like this guy. If he doesn't have Josephine, he make up with the Tetra, which is a more free-to-play option than having a Josephine. You don't have a Fela Jewel? Go with Fran. As for me, I used not to have any of the meta comp, so I went with the budget. If you have been watching my videos then, the way I climb to RTA is by using the relevant free-to-play units like Lauren, Ferd, Fran, Triana, and etc. This could only take you so far though, guys. It could only take me to G1, and I've never reached G2 with it. But the more I play Summoner's War, the more I get new monster, right? And at the moment, I could almost complete the tank shot meta. Look, I have Laika, I have Fela Jewel, Molong, Harmonia, Taranis, Daphnis, and Josephine now. This was not available to me in like the previous seasons. Hey look, we even got a new addition to the tank shot meta right here.
Spoiler alert, it sucks.
So basically what we're doing is just learning from the best. If you guys wanna know how to counter a certain comp, then you can also do it here. Some meta are just about who has faster speed like this one. So basically these are the CC meta versus the CC meta. Whoever has the fastest speed is gonna win. So don't get too obsessed with this kind of match. But this kind of match is interesting. You get to see how this one is a one-shot meta. We know because there's Bastet, there's Odin, and Daphnis. And how these other people is going to counter the one-shot by using Reviver like Taranis and Triana. Triana and Taranis, obviously these are meta. Obviously, they belong to the RTA comp that you need to build if you have them. And of course, just by having an RTA comp doesn't mean that you're gonna get to the top immediately. There's a lot of factor involved in RTA. One of them, of course, is the rune quality, but most of all is the drafting. You need to pay accordingly to the opponent and see what comp beats what comp. But drafting? That's for another video, I guess. Okay guys, that's all for the video. Now I'm sorry you had to learn about the RTA pool from this video instead of getting a one-on-one message from me. Because you know, back then, there were only so little of you, and I could answer each one of you personally. But now, there's only one of me and there's 1,000 of you. I'm happy, but don't get me wrong, if I answer you one by one, I'm gonna die guys, I'm gonna die young. So yeah, I hope this video is useful for you, and I'll catch you later. Bye-bye!